Hi guys, so I got a few DMs in the last couple of weeks regarding what is a pap smear, how is it done, how is it important and when is it needed, what are the instructions, how is it, what do you expect in one, and you know, a lot of questions, etc. So I wanted to make this quick video because I just remembered this. So this is the entire uterus, this is the cervix, this is the ectocervix, this is the endocervix, this is the organ which is called as the mouth of the uterus. A lot of implications in obstetrics and gynecology. And this is the vagina. As you can see, the uterus and especially the cervix, they invaginate the vagina by embryological evolution. So why is this organ so important to be tested? Now, more than the organ, let's come to what is the pap smear again, the topic. Now, what is a pap smear? Pap smear is nothing but a collection of cells from the surface of the cervix to check for abnormal cells. A normal pelvic examination, which you go to your gynecologist, is not a pap smear. A pap smear is a separate test which can be done during a gynec pelvic examination. Now, how is it done? Now, there's something called as a speculum. I don't have one right now. I can show it later. But a speculum is primarily a device used to retract or separate the walls of the vagina so as to expose the cervix. The healthcare provider will use a thin wooden stick called as a spatula or something like this called as a cytobrush. He will use something like a cytobrush to remove these cells from the interior and the exterior of the cervix. After the test is done, he will place the cells from the cytobrush onto a slide. The slide will then be stained by the technique of we learn in microbiology and pathology, and it will be sent for a pap smear. Now, what are the instructions and what do we expect? The patient should not be bleeding. The first and foremost rule is the patient should not be bleeding during a pap smear. You should have abstained from intercourse for at least 24 hours. Avoid smoking. Avoid any form of vaginal medication, douches, pessaries, any vaginal tablets, anything for the last 24 hours before you come for a pap smear, because those will alter with the cells in the vagina and the cells in the cervix. Number one. Number two. It's very, very important when you come for a pap smear, you are prepared mentally for a gynec examination. Because unfortunately in a pap smear, just like a gynec examination, we use a lot of jelly for a gynec examination. In a pap smear, we have to use minimal or no jelly. So the lubrication is not as much as you expect in a normal gynec examination. An important question I was asked, is it painful? I would say not really. It is very much like an outpatient procedure. It will last for maybe a few seconds more than a pelvic examination. And it is a matter of, you know, around 2 to 3 minutes for the test to get done in a good hand. Another question I got asked, what about the cost? Now, it's a normal gynec checkup with an extra test for the lab. So the lab charges roughly vary between 500 to 1000 rupees depending on which lab the smear is sent. And in addition to your gynec consultation, which the doctor will charge you. Most importantly now, I wanted to talk about the cells we see over here. The cells we see are from the ectocervix, and then I mentioned the endocervix over here. Now, these are the cells that undergo the changes in the initial phases of any form of infection, inflammation, and the kind of report you get, you can treat these infections. Inflammation, you can look for a cervical erosion. Erosion is nothing but like there's a scalding of the mouth, of the mucosa, of the cervix. Very, very similar picture to a mouth ulcer, but on the opening of the cervices, the cervix. The other change which can be seen is the change in the cells or the appearance of the cells of the ecto and the endocervix, which is unfortunately the one of the first signs of cervical carcinoma, which is cervical cancer. So, I strongly recommend this procedure to all women who are sexually active, who've changed their sexual partners, specifically those who've had unprotected intercourse. Even if you've had protected intercourse, if you've changed partners because of the small chance of rupture of the condom, it's not only, you know, about wearing a condom for the pregnancy, avoiding pregnancy, and it's also about the infections, the STDs and the STIs which can occur because of not using a condom. Anyone having any bleeding during intercourse, very, very important. You are far away from your periods, and because of the trauma you've had during the intercourse and you notice you are bleeding, So imagine a non-virgin girl who's broken her hymen and now she's having intercourse and she bleeds during intercourse. Very, very important to get a gynec examination, and most likely your gynecologist will advise you a pap smear in that setting. The third important thing is a long chronic cervical erosion. Now, cervical erosion, as I already mentioned, is when the superficial mucosa of the mouth of the cervix is scalded. It is missing and it really, really leads to a lot of white discharge, itching, prolonged infections. Even that is one indication. And your doctor will tell you many more indications, but ideally in a sexually active woman, up to the age of 55 or 60, up to her sexual activity, whichever is longer, she has to get a pap smear at least every 2 years. If the pap smear shows any problem, such as dysplasia, change of the cells, any form of inflammation infection, then your gynec might advise you to do a pap smear even earlier. So that's all I had to say about the pap smear. If you have any more questions, please DM me or please write in the comment section. If you like this video on pap smear, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Good night.